Norma, I would like to extend to you today also the greetings and best wishes of His Eminence Cardinal Lopez Trujillo, the Vatican. I have, before coming back here from Rome a few days ago, spoken to him about the ceremony today, and he wants you to know his prayers and his joy too on this solemn and special occasion. It is an occasion, of course, in which what Christ did when you were baptized, Christ has now filled. Because no matter who baptizes, it is Christ that baptizes. And that is why the moment in which you were reborn and set free from sin and made a daughter of God and a member of the body of Christ was at that moment when Reverend Philip Benham baptized you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Church acknowledges the validity of that baptism, which is why we did not have to baptize you again in this ceremony. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. But what the Lord Jesus has done today is to fulfill that with the gift of His Spirit through confirmation and with the very gift of His body and blood in the Eucharist. You have not received bread and wine today. You have received the risen flesh of Christ. The very same flesh that was conceived in the womb of the Virgin Mary, that was nailed on the cross, the very same body that was buried in the tomb and rose again, the very same body that ascended into heaven and is now seated in the glory of the Father, that is what you have received in this moment. Now, in the Gospel of Life, encyclical, Pope John Paul II says this: when He became baby, God, in Jesus, joined all humanity to Himself. In other words, when God took on a human body, became a man, at that moment, He united every human being to Himself, every human being, from Adam and Eve all the way until the very end of time. Whether they know Jesus or not, they were united with Him because they share the same humanity that He now has. Now, Jesus became human, but He's still human. Just like when He was always God, He always will be God. He's still human today. Every baby in the womb is therefore united with the body of Christ. Every baby in the womb is united with the flesh of Christ. What does that mean? That means that today, when you receive the Holy Eucharist, and Jesus gave you Himself, that body is still united to every human being and to every baby that is in the womb or ever was in the womb. Realize what that means? That means, Father, that every time you receive Holy Communion from now on, as you have done for the first time just a few moments ago, you know what God is doing? He's giving back to you all the babies that were lost through what you did. Giving them back to you. Because they are united with His flesh. When He became a child Himself, all humanity was united to Him. And by coming to you today, what has He done? He has restored the friendship between you and the babies that didn't get a chance to play in the playgrounds. He has given them back to you now in His flesh. That friendship. flesh which is alive, risen from the dead, glorious, conquering the death that spreads through this world by abortion. In the Eucharist is the victory over abortion. Today he has reconciled, he has bridged back that gap, he has taken away that enmity that allowed you to participate in the evil world of abortion. The first time, brothers and sisters, that I entered here in Norma, I started the interview by saying, "So you are the dean of Roe versus Wade?" And she said, "Oh no, I was the dean of Roe versus Wade." Thanks to your baptism, and today, thanks to your confirmation, your reception into